So please come to lie on your mat or on the floor on your... Let's start on the left side. Let's start on the left side. Please come to lie on your left side.
Yes.
So it's just nice to come to lie down on the floor. So please come to rest onto your left side with your knees a bit bent, the legs on top of each other. If you need a blanket in between your knees to make it more comfy, please do so. Please have a pillow that's nice for your head, not too soft, so that you can still move your head. Have your right hand on the floor in front of your chest. And the first movement is to see how fast I can start a vessel. So please bring the back of your head backwards. So the back of the head is the part of your head that is the furthest in the back. Your nose is the part that is the frontest in the front. So all of that, bring it backwards a little bit. And if you need to lift your head to do so, in order not to rub your left ear off or to not to have burn marks on your left ear, so you could lift your head a little bit just to make it easier to slide it backwards. So it's the back of the head backwards. It's not a rolling, so yes, open. If you open up to the ceiling, that feels nice and that's a roll, but we're not going for the roll today. We're going for something else. So keep facing, in a way, keep facing forwards. And then bring the back of your head backwards. You slide the back of your head backwards. And of course, your chin lifts a little bit away from your chest. So you're actually not exactly looking forward, but you start to gaze a little bit from your point of view upwards, but not upwards to the ceiling, but where is upwards? So the back of the head backwards and back again. And at any point, please take a rest, please, double please, take and don't push your limits. Just do what is, stay within your what a concept, stay within what's comfortable. Don't push yourself, but move. You have to do the work, but don't stress. Just move a little bit and you can take a rest wherever, and then continue to move and take a rest and continue to move and take a rest and come back and take a rest. So this is our first movement, the head backwards. Now please bring your attention to your right leg. And the right side of your pelvis, and deep inside your pelvis there's your right hip joint, and on the lowest part of your pelvis there's your sit bones. I mean, on the lowest part there's skin or hair of course, but from a bone skeletal perspective, the lowest part of the skeletal is the right sit bone, ischium. And bring your right sit bone backwards. So think of your right sit bone or your right hip joint, your right sit bone moving backwards, just in the same way as you took your head backwards before. So the sit bone backwards. For me, behind me is the couch, so it's like I would like to touch my behind or onto the couch, or maybe behind you is the wall, or I don't know what is behind you, but bring your right sit bone closer or more facing towards what is behind you. And again, it's not a rolling movement. We're not going for the roll today. So you don't lift your knee and you don't open up towards the ceiling. It's the hip joint backwards. It's an anterior pelvic tilt. You're tilting the pelvis forwards. So we studied this in the last lesson in the pelvic clock, to tilt the pelvis forwards, which means your navel and the part that is in between your belly button and your pubic bone comes forwards, and your sit bone moves backwards, and your right knee can come backwards. There's a couple of things that can help us achieve this movement. For example, with the hands. The hands can feel, and with the hands we're very dexterous, and you could use your right hand to feel the, to help you feel this movement. That what I have been doing all along. You can place your right hand on your right knee, for example, and pretend to push the right knee, and in this way feel the right knee moving backwards in relation to your left knee. Of course, not opening and lifting to the ceiling, just lifting your right leg enough so it can slide. Or you could bend your right foot, your right ankle, and you could bend your right knee a little bit and like bring more tension in your right leg, and like this bring the right leg, the right hip joint backwards. Just to get a better image, a better feel for this movement. And then broaden your attention and bring your attention to both sit bones or to your pelvic floor, and bring your pelvic floor backwards. So think of your pelvic floor moving backwards. And this in turn, of course, makes your belly round. So you could do this on a breath in while you're breathing in. You breathe in, you bring your pelvis backwards. So your chest comes forwards, and maybe this movement trickles up all the way up, like a coupling movement through the spine up to your head, so that the back of your head actually moves backwards. So a connection from this movement of the pelvis up through the spine to the head. And we did this so to feel the difference when you only move the right hip joint or when you move the whole pelvis. It's a slightly different movement. And we do this to look at it from different perspectives, to get a better feel and image for this movement. What else can we do? I thought of a trick. So I have a belt, so I can grab my belt and pull on my belt upwards in order to help my hip joints come backwards. I will show you this on the other side again. In case you're wearing a belt, you can grab your belt and pull your trouser up to help your hip joints or your sit bones move backwards. Let's try this on the other side. So please come to lie onto your right side. And I will also turn, because it's the easiest thing to do, to turn over and show you my backside. So maybe you can see the movement from the other side. So on your lying on your right side, put your legs on top of each other, slightly bend, your left hand standing in front of your chest, and take your head backwards. So start with the head, bring your head backwards, the back of your head backwards. And now maybe this movement is already more clear than it was before, because we already involved the pelvis. So the head backwards. And it's not the shoulders. You don't pull your shoulders backwards. So this is like kind of a constraint when you have your left hand on the floor. This kind of stops you from moving the shoulders, but it's a movement of the spine. So the back of your head backwards. Of course, your chin lifts from your chest. And then bring your awareness to your left hip joint and think of your left hip joint moving backwards. And you could bend your left foot and bend your left knee a little bit to help the left hip joint or the left sit bone to come backwards. Or you can try the belt trick to help with your hand to pull up your trousers to help round to your lower back. But it's not like an overextension of the lower back, but it's a movement that comes from the lowest part of your pelvis, from your sit bones, and thus has this effect on the lower back, on the chest, and we're trying to reach areas. So we're reaching areas on the chest that usually maybe don't move. And because we're looking at this movement in this way, we invite parts of ourselves that don't move to move. And this will have a lot of good. Maybe this will resolve a lot of old things. When these old things that didn't move for ages suddenly start to participate in this basic movement. And then, of course, think of both hip joints and the pubic, the pelvic floor to move backwards. And maybe this movement of the pelvis travels up the spine and invites, or the head responds to this movement of the pelvis also by going backwards. Now, how can we further improve this movement? How can we look at it? How can we make it interesting? How can we discover things that are undiscoverable otherwise? So please come back onto your left side. We continue straight away on the left side and have your right hand as before standing in front of your chest, but your right knee, put it on the floor behind your left knee. So the right knee, somehow arrange yourself. So this will be a bit easier if you're on a couch or in your bed because it's softer and the chest can sink into the floor here. It cannot. And but also in the hard floor, it's interesting to feel the details of this posture. And the right hip joints, because the right knee is lower now, the right knee is hanging down from the hip joint, it kind of pulls, but where does it pull? Where is the pull in the back? And let's look at this interesting new posture from this movement perspective and start to bring your right hip joint backwards and see how you can move your pelvis with this constraint, how you can bring your right hip joint backwards. And by all means, if you want to use your hands to help you feel, because I discovered for myself the hands are a great tool for this lesson to help to feel what's happening in your what is happening, where what is, who's related to whom, who is who. When you bring your hip joint backwards, how does this pull on your spine, on your chest, on your bones, on your muscles, tendons, what else do we have? And how this movement travels up and maybe invites your head to go backwards. So in which ways can you move your pelvis, and in which way are we looking to move the pelvis? So we are looking for the hip joint backward, or both hip joints. You can think of both sit bones. You can think of the pelvic floor to let the pelvic floor face more backwards and thus see in this asymmetric position, what does it do? What kind of movement does it provoke? What kind of relationships does it establish? Or let's turn this around, start the movement with the head. So just rest on your left side like this with your right, with both knees on the floor, the right knee behind the left knee, and start to bring your head backwards, the back of your head backwards. When you bring the back of your head backwards, how the chest bone lifts and how your belly comes forwards and how your hip joints go backwards. And don't push the limits, but of course stay in a range that's comfortable, that feels good. What a concept, to do what feels good and not to push ourselves. And if you stay in this range, if you explore in this range will broaden and larger, become larger. So the area where you feel comfortable will be bigger instead of pushing the limits. I mean, how amazing is that? And of course, this movement of extension that we improve here in detail, we will be able to use it in coming from sitting to standing, from kneeling to standing, in all the pelvic clock movements. It will improve our walking. It will improve many areas of life. And then combine both ends. Tie the loose ends together in this sense. Bring the back of your head backwards. See how that trickles down, and bring the pelvis, your sit bones backwards. And of course, the front side becomes longer and the back side becomes shorter. And then let's take a rest on the back. It's always... that was much needed. Why didn't I cue for this earlier? To take a rest on the back. Ah, that's so nice. And then, so for me, I'm okay now to continue. So I hope you are too. So please roll onto your right side. And again, I will show you my back. So maybe that's interesting to see the movement from the other side. And this time, have your left knee on the floor behind your right knee. And see, does this pull as much, or do you have like a preferred side? Like one side is easier to shorten, one side is easier to lengthen. Does this not pull as much, or does this pull stronger on your spine? Where does it pull? And let's start with the movement of the head. Bring the back of your head backwards, 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 and see how this is on this side. In with this asymmetric situation. So the back of the head, you could think of a large circle that starts at the head and ends at your butt. So the head goes backwards, the back of your head to touch your butt. Okay, so, or let's bring your awareness to your left hip joint, to the left sit bone, and bring your left sit bone backwards, 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 and see where does it pull, where does it push, how does this movement go through your lower back, through your chest, to your head, and invites your head, or pushes, even pushes your head to go backwards. or you can think of your pelvic floor. So both sit bones going backwards. Oh, but it's really asymmetrical. So this kind of really frees the left side to move, does it? In a certain pathway. Okay, and then roll over your back, short rest on the back, back onto your right side. So we have a couple of more movements to help us understand more of this movement, of the basic theme of extension, which is initiated from the head or the pelvis. So this lesson I wanted to teach you for a long time, but I couldn't fit it in because it's quite specialized, this lesson. I think it's quite advanced in the sense you have to have like a refined awareness. So it's good you, if you have done already a couple of videos, be experienced to appreciate these little details. So, but of course, even though it seems small, it can make a big difference. So how do we start? The last couple of movements. Please bring your right knee on the floor behind your left knee and hug yourself as good as that's possible. So hug yourself, maybe with the arms on top of each other and not crossed, but maybe you can. Your preferred way of hugging yourself as it's possible on the floor. And don't have your knees on top of each other, but behind each other. At all time, keep them behind each other. And start with bringing your head backwards. The head backwards, the head backwards, the head backwards, the head backwards. And then also bring the head forwards as if you would like to touch your nose to your knees. As if you would like to touch your nose to your knees. So this is really, you become small and you have to keep the knees in a sequence, not parallel, in a sequence behind each other, and bring your head backwards and bring your hip joints backwards. So you bring your hip joints backwards, the same movement like it was, and then the head forwards and the hip joint forwards, and then the head backwards, and the hip joints backwards. And again, don't do as much as humanly possible, but just stay within your comfort range and explore the details of the movements, and most of all, how you feel the connection of the different start points, the initiation of the movement. Either it's initiated from the head backwards or from the hip joints backwards, or both at the same time. Then change over your legs. So bring your right knee in front of your left knee. Wow, that's different, huh? The right knee in front of your left knee. And of course, to bring the right hip joint backwards. So that's different when the right knee is blocked by the left knee. But still, it is possible. And start the movement with either your right hip joint backwards, or your pelvic floor backwards, or your head backwards, or all at the same time. And also change over your hands. So you can still use your hands to feel all over your chest, to feel how you move, where there's movement, where there's no movement, where you feel you could invite something to move, like under the armpits. Maybe this area could also, like when you bring your head backwards, maybe the ribs underneath your armpits could open up a little bit more and close in the back. It's really like taking some children, the little whip children by the hand and say, come with me, let's do this together. So it's not like therapy where you take a wooden stick and press it hard and bring pain to someone, but it's really like an invitation. So you use soft hands and you feel where can something move, where, because they have fun when they're moving. They are meant to move. They are meant to participate. That's how we are built. And it just feels good if we are allowed to move, or if we are invited to move. Sometimes it really just takes an invitation. Like, we invite our little ribs to move. So, hello, our friends, come participate in this overall movement pattern. Am I still making sense? So, please turn over and try the same, the last couple of movements, this three combination on the right side. Please come to lie on your right side with your, start with your hugging, with hug yourself, and start with your left knee on the floor behind your right knee. And then how would you start the movement? Maybe curl, bring your nose closer to your knees and shorten your front side, your knees closer to your nose, and then bring the head backwards, the back of your head backwards. And then change over your legs. So your left knee finally is in front of your right knee. And also change over your hands, or the position of your hands, to accompany how you accompany your chest. Okay, and then for last time, come to lie on your back, take a rest on your back, just feel how you're now on your back, how, what state your chest is in now, where you can breathe, where you have space to breathe, what kind of contact you have the floor, where the floor supports you. And then, as a final movement, please stand your feet, bring your feet to standing, interlace your hands and bring them behind your head, and with your hands lift your head and also lift your knees, and bring them closer towards each other, your elbows and your knees. Or lower your right leg and your head and lift them again. It's a little bit asymmetrical. That's such a beautiful movement. It's really nice. Or just lift and lower your left leg. Or both. Just a bit of flexion. Okay. So we're done. We're done for today.
you have to practice this at least one more time or from your memory, because it's such an important movement. Just saying, it's up to you, but I invite you to. So please come up to stand. And feel how it is in standing, how you're standing now. Take a few steps. Feel, wow, very nice support. My feet became so soft. Interesting, why did my feet become so soft in this lesson? So many questions. And then when you lift your head, see how you lift your head, because lifting the head is the same movement. And it trickles down the spine, the chest can lift, and it can even move the pelvis, the hip joints backwards. Hip joint still exists when we stand. Sit bone still exists when we stand. So the whole thing is the same, but I mean, we are the same in a way, but we are a different relation to gravity. But maybe looking upwards, looking downwards became a little bit smoother. And yes, so I hope you found this interesting. If you did, if you made some discoveries, please don't hesitate to leave your comment, to share your experience, leave your like if you liked this video. And thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.
And you can feel